Despite the high unemployment rate, which now stands at well over 50%, according to reports, Deputy Prime Minister Philip J. Pearce says his party has been able to stabilize the economy and that it is poised for growth. Mr. Pearce says his party stands a good chance of winning the next general elections. He says his party is united and there is no infighting. Generally speaking, Mr. Pearce says the party has done well under the circumstances.
I think we've gone through the worst, but we can't be complacent. We have to deal with our issues as they relate to productivity. We also have to deal with our issues as it relates to doing business. We have to ensure that we are competitive. We have to ensure that our business processes are streamlined, so we can make it easier for investment, and we also have to attract some direct for foreign direct investment. But I think the signs are good for next year, and to my mind, we've passed the boost.
Speaking on the unemployment situation, Mr. Pierce says his government can only employ a certain amount of people and that the private sector must do its part in creating jobs. Pierce says the government's programs have been heavily criticized, but they have proven to be effective in stemming the tide of unemployment.
Government has to deal with some fiscal realities, and government cannot employ everybody needs to be employed. But we are looking for the private sector, and this is why we have this generous incentives for private investment in business and tourism, hoping that investment can take the slack for unemployed.
Commenting on the impacts report, Mr. Pierre described former National Security Minister Guy Mears' response as opportunistic. Mr. Pierre said the former minister went by for a whole month after the report came out and said nothing, but chose to wait until the spate of homicides occurred to make a statement. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.